But he started the day at 3:14 a.m. by bashing CNN. A few hours later, another apparent bomb addressed to CNN was found in the mail nearby here. The president tweeted again, putting bomb in quotes, downplaying what he called this bomb stuff and worrying about the GOP's midterm chances. Now, those are the actions of a Fox talking head, not a president. So I flew to Charlotte. Well, actually, I've been planning to go there for a while. When I reflected on my coverage of the 2016 election, I regretted that I had never been to a Trump rally. I thought I should have experienced it for myself. Well, as you know, he's having lots of rallies this month, so I had booked this trip before the mail bombs. Walking into the arena, a big screen tells you to sign up for real news by following Trump on Twitter and Facebook. But in talking to the rally goers, I could tell most of them were already signed up. These were the converted. They were here for a political concert, for a celebration. And many of them had been to a Trump rally before. They knew the lyrics to his songs. And sometimes they sang along. Here, let me show you what it's like. This is video I shot from inside the press pen. And it really is a pen. You can see CNN, Fox, NBC reporters working, and all the camera crews on the riser, and then thousands of rally goers all around the room. When you're in that pen, you really do feel like a zoo animal. Now, before the rally, people are gawking at you, taking pictures, saying you're fake news, an enemy of the people. One guy came up and asked me if Sean Hannity was going to be there. Another said he wanted to meet Jim Acosta. But look, there's all kinds of Trump rally goers. Some hardcore fans wear Trump flags on their bodies, but others hang in the back. They don't love everything Trump says, but they still want to see the show. Some folks were rude, calling me names, heckling me during my live shots. They didn't have much interest in a conversation, but others were really friendly. These two guys wanted selfies. We talked about the news and the weather. The thing is, parts of the crowd are primed to chant CNN sucks. But then after they did that, one of the men walked over and said, hey, nothing personal. Another said, we're glad you're here. What you see is the individual versus the collective. You see how someone can fire up a crowd and point energy in a certain direction. Some of them seem to think the enemy of the people stuff is just a performance, like pro wrestling. But others seem to really, truly believe it. And that's the heart of the problem. Trump is leading a hate movement against the media, and he kept it up all this week. No, not everybody in his crowd believes it, but some do. And that is dangerous. Now, you might have heard that TV crews travel to these rallies with security. And that's true. The networks usually don't like to talk about this. We don't want to draw attention to it. But security is there in case anything gets out of hand. So, did I feel like I was in danger there? No, not at all. But the boos and the insults can feel intimidating. And that brings me back to looking for a president, looking for presidential leadership. Here's what it was like in the arena on Friday when Trump started his media bashing.
We must unify as a nation in peace, love, and in harmony. The media has a major role to play. And they do indeed, they have a major role to play as far as tone and as far as everything.
What's newsworthy is what Trump didn't do. He didn't try to tamp down the jeers of CNN after a week of bombs in the mail. Instead, he soaked up the jeers. He reveled in the chants. He wasn't channeling the friendly faces who came over to me earlier and said, we're all people, we all love each other. He wasn't channeling the people who were asking me questions about journalism and wanting to know more. He was fanning the flames. And not just about the media either. When he tells his scary stories about illegal immigration and he rails against Democrats, he's in Fox News pundit mode, not president mode. He makes the crowd angrier. The next day, Saturday, the president rightly tweeted about the evil attack in Pittsburgh. He said, "We must unite to conquer hate." Yes. So when are you going to start?